I'm Suzette Walling. I'm with Cooperative Extension Services, and I work in water quality. We have been working with pet waste concerns because it is a concern for nutrient pollution. And the reason is that stormwater runoff carries pollutants into our streams, and it's not treated. So things like oils and trash and pet waste can pollute our streams. Pet waste has a couple of issues with it. One is that it's a source of pathogens. Most people understand that waste contains pathogens, things like bacteria, viruses, and parasites, and that these pathogens are harmful to people and pets. Less well known is that pet waste is a source of nutrients and contributes to nutrient pollution in our waterways. I work with Dr. Brad Lee in water quality, and our research is really directed on the nutrient pollution problem with pet waste. Pet waste is really just one piece of the nutrient pollution puzzle. Our concern really is that we want to reduce the human additions of nutrients into our soils.
We are focusing on phosphorus because our Kentucky soils are naturally rich in this element, especially here in the bluegrass. So our action step is to reduce excess nutrients we are adding to our soils. This is one way we can protect our waterways.
So to go along with our research, we also want to educate the community, and we're encouraging folks to bag the dew, whether they're at home, whether they're taking the dog for a walk or in their dog park. It's not very glamorous, but it's an important part of protecting our water quality. And when you do it, you can feel good because you've protected your pets, you've protected people, and you've protected the planet. So remember to do your part. It's just four simple steps. Glove it, grab it, turn it, and trash it.